It is a new month, and that means we have a new memory verse and a new theme, as you can see. But first, we need to do something else. What is that first thing we do when we come to church? You got it. We sing our welcome song, and I have some instruments to help me. Ready? Let's go ahead and stand up. Who came to church today? Church today, church today. Who came to church today? And we're glad you came. Came to church today, church today, church today. Came to church today, and we're glad you came. Up next, I have another instrument that kind of looks like a tambourine, but it doesn't have the bells. I'm gonna use it like this and hit it. Ready? Came to church today, church today, church today. Came to church today, and we're glad you came. And last but not least, I have my favorite instruments that I always have with me, my hands. Came to church today, church today, church today. Came to church today, and we're glad you came. All right, are you ready to practice that new memory verse that I told you about? Great. It starts like this. God's way is perfect. 2 Samuel 22:31. Short and sweet, right? Let's try it again. God's way is perfect. 2 Samuel 22:31. Awesome. Let's do it one more time. Since it's so short, we can keep practicing it all the time. God's way is perfect. 2 Samuel 22:31. Great job. Now, I hope you all can learn that one really fast. You can send in some videos to nursery@kingdom.global. Okay, go ahead and watch our Bible story. See you later.
Just follow me through.
Who?
Who?
Follow me through.
Oh, hi, friends. Hola. I'm Luis, the handyman. Today, I'm watering all the seeds I just planted in my little garden here. I'm growing tomatoes right here. And over here, I'm planting strawberries. And then this spot is going to have peppers. That is spicy. You know, this garden reminds me of our story today. Do you want to help me build it? Great! All right, let's put it on the story fence. Hammers up, little builders. Ready? Uno, dos, tres, hammer! Great job, little helpers. You can put your hammers down. Now we just need our story tools. Yep, we have everything we need. Today's true story from the Bible begins in the very beginning, when God created the most perfect garden. It had big tree, beautiful flowers, and lots of plants. Some of them even had food on them. And there were so many animals. Look at this place. I told you it was perfect, and God made it all. But he wasn't done. As beautiful and perfect as the garden was, God knew it needed his most amazing creation. So God made people. He called the man Adam. Now wave to the kids, Adam. And the woman was called Eve. Now the garden truly was perfect. God gave Adam an important job to do. God told him to name all the animals and take care of them. Let's see if you know the names of these animals. Ready? What's this guy's name? Yeah, frog, that's right. Okay, who is this? Yes! It's a bunny rabbit! Okay, now, this one is harder. Ready? What's his name? Yes! He's a kangaroo! Boinky, boinky! Great job! So, Adam and Eve lived in God's wonderful garden, and they knew that God's way is perfect. They could eat fruit from any of the trees, except for one. In fact, that was the only rule. God told them to never, ever, ever, ever eat that one fruit. Oh no! What are they doing? Is Eve going to eat the fruit? Everybody say, oh no! Ready? Oh no! No! Eve ate the fruit! Wait, now what is she doing? She's handing it to Adam. Everybody say, oh no! Ready? Oh no! No! They both ate the fruit. They disobeyed God. And because they didn't do the things God's way, God had to send them away from his beautiful garden. God still loved Adam and Eve very much. They still had food to eat and animals to take care of, but everything was a lot harder. It would have been so much better if they had followed God's way. Because remember, God's way is perfect. When God wants you to do something, remember, his way is perfect. So jump, jump, and go God's way. Hey there, Holly. Tell me, whose way is perfect?
God's way is perfect. Yes, it's true. Now let's hear it from you. Tell me, whose way is perfect?
God's way is perfect. That's the truth, friends. You better believe it. Adios!
Did you like this week's story? You liked it? I liked it too. Did you see one of these? Were there any plants in the story? There were plants in the story. And what other things that God created were in the story? That's right. And that's also right. Oh, I see we have great listeners. You were listening to the story. God created all of those things. Isn't God amazing? Yes. Yes, God is amazing. And we also learned whose way is perfect? God's way is perfect. And because God's way is perfect, we should always do whatever God tells us to do. So we should jump to it and do what God tells us to do. So I hope you had a wonderful time with us this week. We learned a new Bible verse. We have a new story. We talked about how God's way is perfect. And guess what? One more thing, since it's a new month, it is First Wednesday, and it's time for yoga. So I look forward to seeing you on Wednesday for yoga with Miss Erica. It is always fun, so I hope to see you there. Let's say a prayer before we go. Dear God, thank you for your true word, the Bible. Thank you for your word that we can learn that your way is perfect. Help us to do the right thing and follow your way. We pray for our families and our friends. Lord, we pray that you keep us all safe. We love you and we praise you. In Jesus' name, amen. Have a great week and see you on Wednesday for yoga.